Hi friends, my name is Nils, Cyrils Brettspiele, and today another in a nutshell with a kids game. The translation would be up and down, and today we are talking about meerkats. So, yeah, these little meerkats here, they are going up and down. Yeah, funny. Let's take a closer look to what is in the box and how it works. So you have four different colors: green, blue, red, and yellow. Each player has two meerkats, one with a helmet. I hope you can see the helmet here. Yellow was a good choice here, with a helmet, and one without. Both have magnets, so they being attached to each other. Then you have these tokens here with friends on it. A couple of friends, each friend twice. So you have this turtle, you have this maybe a rabbit, I don't know, a spider and a frog. You have a box. The box is really important for the game. Just to let you know, you have a die with 3 feet, which means move 3 spots, 2 and 1. And we have some super meerkat tokens called, or special tokens. This means dig through a wall or a hedge. This means reroll your die. And this means add 2 to your movement. You can collect as many of these tokens as you want over the course of the game and use them all simultaneously or in different turns. What you're doing is you're preparing this box. Each single player starts on one of these holes here. You put the meerkat without the head here and the other one attached from the bottom underneath. I show it to you, give me a shortcut. You do it like this. Both are through the magnets attached to each other. You do that for all the four players. Successfully all the four players. Now you take 4 of your tiles, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the other 4 goes back into the box. So you assemble these 4 puzzle tiles like a path, as shown here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you flip over the first one, and this is the first friend you have to visit. In this case, yellow has to visit the spider first. Keep in mind, you cannot go through the hatch unless you have one of these tokens. Each player gets one of these tokens randomly, so give them a good shuffle, and then each player takes one of these tokens, like this here, re-roll again. So now what you're doing is, on your turn, rolling a die, and if it's just 1 foot, you go along the path until you reach that. First of all, it's allowed to stay with more meerkats on the same spot. Totally fine. Second of all, let's imagine you roll a 2. You can go in here, fulfill, and exit the spot on the same turn. When you fulfill that one, you take off this puzzle tile here, throw it back into the box. However, you still must go back to the hole indicated here because you don't have it. When you reach the closest hole, like here, in this case, immediately flip over the board and everybody starts from here. When a player, if in any case, visited already his friend and has this symbol like this here, so a hole in here, he can just flip over his next puzzle tile and go hunting for his next friend. If for any reason he not visited on the other side of the board his friend before flipping over the tile, he gets an additional of these super meerkat tokens and has right now 2 of these tokens here. However, he has still to visit his friend because he didn't visit his friend first. Whoever completed his row completely and visit all of his friend is the winner of up and down. And like always in my In a Nutshell edition, I will talk to you a little bit about the experiences of this game. Obviously, this is a kids game, what I mentioned before, and the theme is kids friendly, and the components are kids friendly. Always, or not always, but a lot of times in these kids friendly games, there's a lot of material, a lot of cool material, cool in terms of I mean, playing on two sides of the board. I mean, that's obviously, and rolling a die and just moving one, two, or three spaces is not the best mechanic ever, and not a expert gamer's game. This is a kid's game, and when you are moving around and you wanted to visit your friends and you're very close to one of these holes, ah, by the way, in the tunnel system, you have the hole in the middle. So, and then you're very close before you met your friend, and then flips over. Oh, you wanted to visit here, the spider, as you can see, and then you flip over, and the red one has to go all the way up around here. You can easily imagine how a kid scream and say, "Oh no, whoa, 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 don't do that!" Things like that. That is so hilarious to see kids growing up in a friendly environment with games, and then, of course, from time to time, you have to bring something new, something fresh to the table. This is obviously something new and something fresh, and flipping this board is the most important part of this game and the most funniest part in the game. So, especially when it comes close to you getting to your friend and someone else flip that board over, that can create a lot of fun while these kids are screaming and playing. Maybe I mentioned that before, but I just wanted to let you know. Sometimes I'm trying out these games in my preschool. My little girl is going to the preschool some days a week, and I'm trying out with the elder kids this games like this one here, and they love games like this. And it's always amazing to see how these, I would call them simple. Technically, these are simple games, but with cool components can create so much fun, an enjoyable 1.5 hours at this preschool. And it's hilarious that these kids can focus on a game for 20 minutes or 25 minutes, even if they are usually sitting in front of a TV only still for 20 minutes in a row. Yeah, if you ever have the chance to check out Up and Down from Ravensburger, please do it. And yeah, bring your kids to the next convention, to the next friendly local gaming store, and try out games like this for entertain your kids. This is much more fun. And believe me, I have a little girl. I mentioned that before, and you saw Judy maybe before in my videos. When she's playing games, board games, she's unbelievable happy. When she's just watching TV, I mean, she could get grumpy. So believe it or not, games, that's what you should entertain your kids with. That was another in a nutshell, Cyrils Brettspiele. My name is Nils. See you next time. Bye bye.